Hello everyone, and welcome back to the channel. So, in the last episode of Roleplayer Stories, I expanded upon my first foray into writing and roleplaying. Now, with the experience I had at the time, such as it was, I had expected that when I went into role-playing this time, that similar things would happen. I would be pretty much on my own and having to rely only on myself. And if my character wasn't powerful enough to defend himself against everybody else's machinations, then I would just get killed off again. Funny how that works. You think everybody else is out to get you, you treat them as such, and then everybody ends up ganging up on you. Yeah, this time I will chalk it up to paranoia. Though not without precedent. Anyway. So, what happened to me was, I ended up actually joining a group called the Mandalorian Bounty Hunters Guild. I didn't know it was a role-playing group at the time, but once I, you know, talked to everybody and started reading character bios, I decided, okay, well, I'll try it, since I was and still am a Star Wars fan, and a fan of the Mandalorians in particular. Now, the one thing I had done was decided that I would design my character's combat style first, and worry about all the other stuff later. Other stuff being personality, backstory, and everything else. Now, one thing I was a fan of was the Galactic Empire. Still am. So, I had created my character to be a former scout trooper. That would carry over into a later character, but right now, let's just focus on what I did have at the time. Now, the combat style I designed was around assassination. Using technology from things like Shadow Troopers, the cloaking technology of the Shadow Trooper, and combining it with a scythe. A double-bladed beam scythe. Now, obviously, one of the complaints about the beam scythe was it didn't look like a Star Wars weapon. Well, no kidding, it was from Gundam Wing. More specifically, the Death Scythe Hell model of Mobile Suit. What happened was my character would go invisible, get in close, and activate the scythe just as I got in range. Well, activate the scythe only when I was ready to attack. Now, there are a few inherent weaknesses of using this sort of fighting style, but at the time, my use of cloaking tech was considered, what's that term? Overpowered. And, you know, to an extent, I can actually see where they were coming from. I mean, it's especially true if you're not used to dealing with enemies that can use cloaking tech. You'll have absolutely no idea what to do against them. Now, obviously, enemies that use the Force could counter cloaking tech fairly easily, but for the average thug that the Mandalorian Bounty Hunters Guild had to deal with, or just they tended to deal with, no. They would have to be a lot more crafty in order to deal with my character. It actually was to the point that cloaking tech had to be heavily regulated, stuff like that. I mean, you know you're doing something crazy when people make rules around it as a response. Or just say, you know you've ruffled some feathers when you've caused people to actually react specifically to your character. And, yeah, okay, fair enough. My character was considered overpowered, fine. Now, what happened next, like, because I just kept trying to introduce new technology all the time. A particular piece of technology was ripped off from the Providence Gundam, which was the use of the Dragoon system to attack enemies from multiple directions. Again, we're running on the premise that my thought process was, okay, well, I still need to keep going. I still need to make my character more able to defend himself against any threat, because I found out that indeed some enemies would be force sensitive and even use lightsabers, so I wanted to create a countermeasure against that. And I did that in the form of like I said, the Providence Gundam, because I thought, well, okay, even if a Jedi or a Sith can block, you know, multiple shots coming from, you know, one direction, like in front of them, then I don't think that they would, or should say, just because they can block everything in front of them, doesn't mean they could block everything from all directions. So, running on that premise, I decided to try and copy the Providence Gundam's Dragoon system. Now, obviously, one of the complaints was it's overpowered, it doesn't look like a Star Wars weapon, even though it was science fiction. And yeah. But I just pushing and pushing, and it really annoyed a lot of people. But, you know, I kept thinking, okay, well, these people just want me to be easier to kill off. That's why they don't want me to do these things. That's why they don't that's why they don't want me to have these kind of weapon systems, because they want me to be weak enough to take out. Or brain to heal if they think I'm getting too uppity. I ended up trying to market all sorts of new tech in my own group. That was an offshoot, which was Deathbolt Industries. Wait, no, it wasn't Deathbolt Industries. It was Deathbolt's Armory and R&D Lab. And honestly, at the time, I should have checked with the other admins. But I was convinced, you know, it's like, it's better to ask for forgiveness than permission, based on what I had already gone through. In any case, I was belligerent, I kept pushing my ideas on others, and then eventually, yeah, sure, there were some bad actors trying to, you know, be power hungry, and but there were others who were genuinely just concerned. So my storefront ended up getting frozen out of the Mandalorian Bounty Hunters Guild. I got kicked out, and I ended up burning a lot of my bridges there. Obviously, though, this wasn't the last time I would RP. Just, it wouldn't be for a while later, until I created my own group. But that is a story for another day. I've been your Bishop, and I thank you all for listening. Feel free to like, rate, comment, subscribe. Tell me your stories of role-playing adventures. And how you got into it. Maybe some of your early days. Until next time, have a great day and happy gaming.